Assalamu alaikum dear students. Students, we are starting with the revision of the another chapter. We are starting with organic chemistry now, which we have completed a far back. So we are going to start with the chapter, that is your chapter number 10, haloalkanes and haloarenes. Dear students, if we talk about the introduction of your haloalkanes and haloarenes, we simply say that when any particular, suppose this is your hydrocarbon, when any particular hydrocarbons, hydrogen is replaced by X. What is X? X is your halogen. That is the reason we call it haloalkanes, haloarenes. You know that your methane is an alkane, out of which we have substituted one of the hydrogen with X. That is, it can be your Cl, Br, I or F. We are having only four halogen compounds, that is your fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine. So when we have substitution of one hydrogen, now let me tell you one more important thing. The carbon which we are observing right now is your sp3 hybridized carbon. How you will remember this, which is sp3 and sp2? The carbon which is having all the hands free, carbon jisme charo hath pe free groups lage hue ho, such a carbon is called your sp3 hybridized carbon. But the carbon which is involved in the double bond, such a carbon is known as sp2 hybridized carbon. I hope I have explained you before also this one. So you may be remembering. Once more we are just recalling the things, fine. So the carbon which is having your single-handed all the groups, that is known as your sp3 hybridized carbon. And the carbon which is involved in the double bond, that is your sp2 hybridized carbon. So when we talk about the replacement of the hydrogen, one of the hydrogen or two of the hydrogen is replaced by your X, that may be chlorine, fluorine, bromine, iodine, well, then we say that it is your haloalkanes. Let me tell you, you have to remember only alkanes. We are not talking about the other substances. We are just focusing mainly on the alkanes. What about haloarenes? Arenes means the aromatic benzene ring. When you talk about the replacement of one hydrogen, you may be asking that, ma'am, in the structure we are having all the carbons and we are not representing hydrogen. But when we write the complete structure, one structure, we know that each of the carbon is holding one hydrogen. So when we substitute any one hydrogen with X, we call such a compound as a haloarenes. Those are arene compounds, that is your aromatic benzene ring compounds. Look, so that is the starting of the chapter, that what we are going to study in this chapter. We know we are studying the chemical properties, physical properties and the preparations of the particular compounds. Dear student, next is your classification. So let me tell you, in the classification, we have seen that depending on the number of the halogens, we go for writing the compound names. For example, monohaloalkanes, dihaloalkanes, trihaloalkanes. So this mono means one, di means two, tri means three, tetra means four. That is what you are knowing. Depending on the amount of your X, you are writing their names. So that is the classification. Then how do we go for naming them? One more important thing, same you will be doing for your aromatic benzene rings, arenes. You will write monohaloarenes, dihaloarenes, trihaloarenes. When you write their name other than the IUPAC, you know you are going to write their positions. When you go for having dihaloalkanes, that is two halogens in one particular compound, that is called your, you are going to have ortho, meta and para. Those examples can be represented over here. Next, when we talk about the compound containing now, dear students, very important one, compound containing sp3 hybridized carbon. What did I say? The carbon whose all the hands are free and holding each particular group. It may be hydrogen, it may be something else, but along with that, one X. Okay, so in this compound, you are able to see that X means your halogen attached to the carbon which is having single-handed hydrogens and R. So when this kind of the carbon is there, we call it as a primary carbon. Fine. And this is your sp3 hybridized. Similarly, in this we are able to see the carbon is having two R. Those R are the alkyl groups. It means that when this middle carbon is in the contact with two more carbons, such a carbon is called secondary carbon. So your compound is secondary. In the last structure, you are able to see that at the place of three hydrogen, there are three alkyl groups and one S. It means this is your tertiary carbon. So tertiary halide, primary halide, secondary halide, and tertiary halide. Quaternary is not possible as our fourth hand is occupied by X. Is it clear? Quaternary कब होगा? जब आपके चारों हाथों पे R लगा हो, R possible ही नहीं है चारों हाथों पे क्योंकि एक हाथ से compulsory आपको X hold करना है. That is the reason we have primary, secondary and tertiary. Dear student, this is the first type which is called alkyl halides or you can say haloalkanes. Simple formula is RX. Is it clear? This is your sp3 hybridized first structure. Second, if we talk about, it is allyl halides. Allylic halides. Allylic halides are the one in which this is suppose your carbon to which the S is joined. In this case, your this carbon on to which X is connected to carbon which is involved in double bond formation. What does this mean? आपका ये वाला कार्बन कैसा है? sp3 hybridized ही है क्योंकि इसके चारों हाथ free है. But ये कार्बन दूसरे ऐसे कार्बन के साथ contact में है जो double bond formation में involved है. Such a kind of is called as allylic carbon. As you are able to see this structure, we have two hydrogens, so XCH2, single bond, double bonded carbon. So we call this as a allylic dihalide. Allylic halide. So this is your second type in which we are writing sp3 hybridized. Further, if we talk about benzylic halide, you are able to see that the carbon which is having X. It means your this particular carbon, the carbon which is having X, such a carbon is having in contact with your aromatic benzene ring. When you have the aromatic benzene ring over here, you can call it as a benzylic halide. But dear student, remember we are just talking about sp3 hybridized carbon. We are not talking about sp2 hybridized carbon. After this, we are going to see sp2 hybridized carbon. So you have to remember this. Structures they may ask you in the exam and go for making sp3 hybridized structures or sp2 hybridized structures. Now we are able to see compound containing sp2CX bond. Now dear students, sp2CX bond means such a carbon which is directly involved in double bond formation. When this is having X, this kind of the carbon, after ye jo carbon hai, that is your sp2 hybridized carbon. Carbon ke do haath occupied hai, matlab wo sp2 hua. Acha, agar teen haath occupy hote to sp hota. Is it clear? Single single carbon carbon single bond, sp3 hybridized carbon carbon double bond, sp2 hybridized, and carbon carbon triple bond, sp hybridized. Is it clear? That is what we have studied in class 11. First structure we have vinylic halide. In vinylic halide, we are having the single X connected to the carbon which is directly involved in double bond formation. Then we have aryl halides. Again, aryl halides, in that what we were doing? We were connecting the benzene ring to the carbon and that carbon was attached with the halogens. In this case, what we are doing? We are completely removing this C and what we are doing? We are just joining the halogen directly with the carbon, which is involved in the double bond formation. So dear student, in both examples, you are able to see that directly your halogen is connected to the carbon which is having the double bond formation. So that is your sp2 hybridized. Okay, these two type of the compound formations are very important. That is what you have to remember. Next, if we talk about, we have seen with the nomenclature. Nomenclature means naming the compound. How do we name them? So dear student, you are able to see there are two systems always remember. name, one is IUPAC name. The common name is a tribal name. It comes sometimes from the sources. ठीक है, कहाँ से ऑप्टेन हुआ उसके हिसाब से उसका ट्राइबल नेम मतलब कि कॉमन नेम होता है. सेकंड होता है IUPAC, इंटरनेशनल यूनियन ऑफ प्योर एंड अप्लाइड केमिस्ट्री. सो डिपेंडिंग ऑन दैट हाउ यू कम टू नो दैट वेदर इट इज अ कॉमन नेम और IUPAC नेम. हियर स्टूडेंट, इन द कॉमन नेम द सोर्सेज आर टेकन, बट इन द IUPAC मिथ इट प्रोव्यू डिपेंडिंग ऑन द कार्बन नंबर. सो इट व्हेन इट इज कमिंग विथ इट प्रोव्यूटेन such a kind of the compounds are your IUPAC, so that you can go for referring it over here. Common name N-propyl bromide. When we talk about N-propyl bromide, we are talking about the alkyl bromide. Is it clear? Alkyl bromide. Remember, common name alkyl halide. Very simple. Common name में आपको पहले alkyl लिखना है, फिर जो आपका halogen है वो लिखना है. But IUPAC में कैसे लिखना है? पहले लिखोगे हेलो, फिर लिखोगे अल्केन. आर यू एबल टू सी द डिफरेंस ओवर हियर? एन प्रोपाइल ब्रोमाइड, दैट इन दिस वन व्हाट डू वी से? वन ब्रोमो प्रोपेन. तो एक में आप क्या करते हो, अल्काइल पहले लिखते हो, ठीक है, और हेलोजन बाद में लिखते हो. कौन से सिस्टम? कॉमन सिस्टम. बट IUPAC में क्या करते हो? पहले हेलोजन लिखते हो और फिर अल्केन लिखते हो. सो दिस इज द डिफरेंस यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. Second structure, isopropyl chloride, that is a 2-chloro-propane. Is it clear? Third also you are able to see, we write isobutyl chloride, that is 1-chloro-2-methyl-propane. Now dear student, you may have the doubt that when we go for numbering it, like 1, 2, 3. So how do we go for naming them? When we talk about the naming, you don't have to bother about the position. आपको पोजीशन ध्यान में नहीं रखनी है, आपको ये ध्यान में रखना है कि कौन सा लेटर पहले आएगा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, क्लोरीन सी से स्टार्ट होता है जबकि मिथाइल एम से स्टार्ट होता है. अगर मिथाइल फर्स्ट पोजीशन पे भी होता तो हम उसको बाद में ही लिखते. क्यों? क्योंकि एम बाद में आता है, सी पहले आता है. 1-chloro-2-methyl-propane. इज इट क्लियर? यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द अल्फाबेटिकल मैनर. दैट इज हाउ यू कैन गो फॉर राइटिंग देयर नेम्स. दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट हैलोहैलोजन्स. What about halohalides? Same. You are having the common system and IUPAC system. Also, let me tell you, sometimes the common name and IUPAC name both are same. कभी कभी कुछ names ऐसे हैं जो IUPAC में भी consider किए गए हैं और same ही आपके common system में भी consider किए गए हैं. For example, bromobenzene. So here same IUPAC name is bromobenzene. Metadibromobenzene. अच्छा, meta, ortho, para. ये जब भी लिखा हो कॉमन नेम, बट पोजीशन बताई हो तो IUPAC नेम. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, मेटा डाई ब्रोमो बेंजीन. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे क्या लिखा हुआ है? 1,3-dibromobenzene. सिमिलरली वी हैव सिमेट्रिकल ट्राई ब्रोमो बेंजीन, वी राइट इट 1,3-5-5-bromobenzene. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द डिफरेंस. हाउ डू वी गो फॉर राइटिंग द डिफरेंसेस ओवर हियर? दैट इज ऑर्थो, मेटा एंड पैरा. Also, dear student, if you remember when we talked about the we say about the alkenes which are containing the X. So in this also what happened? We studied over there that what happens if you have the dihalide. अगर आपके पास dihalide है तो आपको पता है वो दो टाइप से possible है. It can be vicinal, it can be geminal. What is vicinal dihalide and geminal dihalide? Vicinal is one in which your halogens are attached to the adjacent carbons. अगर दो carbons neighbor हो और वो दोनों neighbors के ऊपर XX लगा हुआ हो दोनों के पास, तो we call it as a vicinal dihalide. बट जब एक ही carbon पे दोनों halogen लगे हुए हो तो we call it as a geminal dihalide. So you have to remember this, very important, vicinal dihalide and geminal dihalide. You can go for writing examples also. 1, 2 dichloroethene. Similarly, you can go for writing 1,1 dichloroethene. Are you getting? So this is how you can go for writing the examples of your vicinal and geminal dihalides. Yes, here is your example, ethylene dichloride. So you can write that is geminal dihalide. And vicinal, that is your adjacent, just how I explained. एक दो first and second carbon पे लगा हुआ आपका विजिबल है, और अगर एक ही कार्बन पे दोनों हैलोजन्स लगे हुए हो तो वो जेमिनल है. सो दिस इज द एग्जांपल गिवन फॉर योर विजिबल डाइहैलाइड एंड जेमिनल डाइहैलाइड. लेट मी टेल यू, इट इज ओनली पॉसिबल व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट डाइहैलाइड्स. ट्राइहैलाइड्स में ये पॉसिबल नहीं है. मोनोहैलाइड्स में भी ये पॉसिबल नहीं है. इट इज पॉसिबल ओनली इन द डाइहैलाइड. इज इट ओके?